We are, the patient's rights movement developed an idea that says that doctors need to listen to patients, which is a good idea, but then it becomes, particularly when it comes to pain, pain is what the patient says it is, where he says it is, when he says it, therefore the patient is just telling the doctor, you know, this is where my pain is, and you're just gonna have to treat it. At the same time, come out with patient-doctor evaluations. The patient is able to say the doctor did a good job or not. Very blunt, very, very vague questions. Did the doctor treat your pain? If the answer is no too often, the doctor gets dinged. There's problems with, you can be lose compensation, you can be fired, you can lose your hospital privileges, etc. You get too many of these. And pretty soon these become levers by which the patient says, I want more pills. Because I'm telling you, doc, where the pain is, when I say it is, where I said it, where I tell you it is. Pretty soon there's this feeling that the doctor really isn't there to provide clinical expertise as much as simply validate what the patient says and as this thing begins to develop, provide pills to the patient. A key moment in all this is when a certain medical institutions decide that pain now needs to be called the fifth vital sign. Fifth vital sign was an enormous, a pivotal moment in all this, convincing older school docs that they needed now to get with the program. Because it was these VA, JCO, which accredits hospitals, all these institutions were saying, this is now how we need to view pain. And patients began, and doctors began to say, okay, except for pain is not a vital sign. It's not something that measures how alive you are, like a pulse, which you can measure independently, objectively every day.